Hello and welcome to my channel where we talk all things health and wellness. Mold illness has become more and more recognized lately, and for good reason. It can make you really sick. This video is the second part in a three-part series on mold. If you missed the first one, don't worry. It's going to show up in the end card at the end of this video so you can go back and watch it. And if you haven't already, make sure that you hit the subscribe and notification bell so that you don't miss that third video when that one comes out too. In today's video, I'm going to help you start to figure out if mold illness is a factor for you. Okay, so let's say you found mold in your house, or maybe you suspect it in your current house, in a past house, or maybe even in your office, and you think you might have gotten sick from it. What do you do about it? One thing that's important to know is that most conventional doctors are not trained in mold illness. And then, even out of the doctors that are, if you ask 100 different doctors how to test for mold illness, you will likely get 100 answers. Now, that's what makes this so confusing. It can be really difficult to navigate on your own. If you'd like my help with it, I'm going to put a link in the description box below to book a consult. But I hope that you find this video and my first one in the series and the third one as well super helpful. Now, luckily for you, I have worked with over a dozen different doctors on my own mold illness, so I've got a pretty good understanding of a variety of different ways that you could go about testing for it and treating it as well. In this video, I'm going to tell you some of the best ways to test for mold illness at a variety of price points. Now, number one is called the VCS. That stands for visual contrast sensitivity. This test is available online for only $5, so it's a really inexpensive way to get started. All you need to do for a VCS test is go to vcstest.com, and it will walk you through the instructions of how to calibrate your computer. Essentially, it's a series of circles with different contrast sensitivities depending on your level of biotoxin illness, which can relate to either your exposure to mold or to Lyme. You're gonna have an easier or harder time determining which direction these lines within the circles are facing. So I know it sounds a little bit complicated, but once you get on the website, it really walks you through it, makes it really easy. It probably only takes about 10 minutes to do the test. And again, it's only $5. So it's a really quick, easy, and cheap way to get a simple screening to see if you potentially have biotoxin illness. Now, this test also has 92% sensitivity. So it's actually fairly accurate for something that's so cheap and easy. Number two is a urine mycotoxin test. This one is preferred by most of the doctors that I've worked with, can be really pricey, however. Now, this is a urine test that you can take in your home, and it looks for an excretion of the metabolites of the various molds. So this is going to be able to tell you specifically which types of molds you've been exposed to, because the metabolites that break down in the urine are going to be different depending on the mold. That makes it really useful to follow throughout your treatment. Let's say in the beginning you have really high levels of metabolites of Stachybotrys, you're going to want to see that number go down with treatment over time. And if not, you know you're not on the right treatment path. The urine mycotoxin test can only be ordered through a registered provider, so you're going to need to seek out a qualified practitioner to order this for you. Now, a third test that can be really useful when evaluating mold illness is called the Marcon's test. Marcon's stands for multiple antibiotic resistant coagulase negative staph. That's a really fancy way of saying you have a staph infection in your nose. Marcon's test is a swab, a nasal swab. It's about this long. It feels like it goes into your brain, but it doesn't. And the doctor is going to insert the swab up through your nasal cavity as high as possible, move the swab around, and then send that off to the lab. The lab is then going to analyze it and tell you which types of antibiotic-resistant coagulase negative staph you have in your nose. Now, why do you have staph in your nose? That's a great question. That's really common with water-damaged buildings. So if you are in a water-damaged building, there's mold there, you have mold illness in your body, there's a really good chance that you have Marcon's in your nose as well. Now, I often see Marcon's forgotten by treatment providers, unfortunately, but it's a really big piece of the puzzle. It's way too long for me to go into today exactly what it does when it cleaves the melanocyte stimulating hormone, which impacts your adrenals and your hypothalamus and all that kind of stuff. But trust me when I tell you, you want to deal with Marcon's, because if you don't, you're never really going to get better from that mold exposure. Now, the fourth way that you can go about evaluating mold illness in your body is Dr. Shoemaker's labs. Dr. Shoemaker is one of the original researchers on mold illness. He is the one that coined the term CIRS, or chronic inflammatory response syndrome. I'm going to talk about that a little bit more in the third video of this series, so make sure you hit that notification bell so you don't miss that one. Now, Dr. Shoemaker has been studying Sears for a long time, and he's come up with a list of labs, which you can find on his website, and he finds them to be invaluable to follow throughout the course of treatment for mold illness. So his website is survivingmold.com. If you click on the lab section, it's going to detail out all of the labs for you. You're going to be things like MMP9, MSH, TGF-beta, a whole bunch of letters and numbers are going to be in there. But basically, these are inflammatory markers in the body. Mold causes a lot of immune dysregulation and a lot of inflammation. And Shoemaker Labs will help follow that. And again, if you're on the right track for treatment, you're going to see those inflammatory numbers come down, similar to the urine mycotoxin test, where you're going to want to see those numbers come down as well through treatment. Now, I can't stress enough how little conventional doctors understand about mold illness. If you try to approach the topic with them, they most likely are going to think you're talking about a mold allergy, and they'll probably send you to an allergist for a skin prick test. Mold allergy and mold illness have nothing to do with each other. They are not related in the slightest. So testing for mold allergy is really not useful if you have mold illness, also known as SIRS, like I said, that chronic inflammatory response syndrome. So I would encourage you to not really waste your time trying to explain mold illness to your doctor, trying to get them to understand it. They just weren't trained in it. It's just not in their scope of practice. Instead, I would highly recommend you find a doctor that is trained in mold illness. There's a couple top doctors out there, and you can ask your provider if they've been trained in these methods. So some of my favorite mold illness doctors are Dr. Neil Nathan, Dr. Richie Shoemaker, and Dr. Jill Carnahan. So if you are searching for a doctor, you can interview them and ask them, you know, what protocols, what methods have you been trained in? What doctors have you trained with? And if they've trained under or with or follow the protocols of any of those doctors that I just mentioned, chances are they're going to be a really good provider and have a good understanding of mold illness. In the next video, I'm going to tell you what you can do to start healing from mold illness. So make sure you hit that notification bell so that you're notified when that comes out. I hope you found today's video helpful. If you need my help navigating any of this, again, just check out that link in the description box below, and I'll see you in the next video.